Wonderful drama.
Well, hello and welcome to Montreal. Welcome to Canada, the home of the Villeneuve's father and son, and today the home of free practice.
Okay, when you're ready, let's go. Thank you. Trivia for the next 15 minutes at least. And that was a really good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Right, let's have you in at the end of this lap, please. If today's practice is anything to go by, we're in for an exceptional weekend of Formula One. Sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat. Excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. Okay, we can take you this lap. We'll be right back.
And that's it. Welcome back, everybody. We're here in Canada at the wonderful Circuit Gilles Villeneuve. Who's going to come out fastest of all in the next hour? Yes, it's time for qualifying.
All set, we're ready to go, so let's get the car out onto the track. Down to P13. One lap of fuel left now, the tank's pretty much empty. stopping this lap.
With qualifying wraps up now, we have our grid lineup for the... Back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to the variants of this track back in 1978, and it was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. It's one of the fastest races of the season here at the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve, with around 60% of this 2.7-mile circuit taken at full throttle. There are 14 corners to navigate, the very last of which has its very own infamous history and could be the cause of a safety car today. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Poole lines up on pole position, and the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Perez, Leclerc, Russell, Stroll, Ricciardo, Joe, Tsunoda, Fernando Alonso, Bottas, Norris, Gasly, Hülkenberg, Sargeant, Ocon, Albon, and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Alongside me here in the commentary box today, former racing driver extraordinaire, Naomi Schiff. Now, Ant, you know us. Professionals as we are, we don't listen to rumours all the time, just some of the time. And in the case of this driver, I think we were right to listen to those rumours because they were true.
Well, every driver has their own characteristics and how they deal with these situations. But a lot of it may have to do with whether the seat they're in currently is secured or not. And you know, I would say to these drivers, try not to think too much about it. Make sure you focus on your performances on track, because that's what's going to make the difference.
Okay, so everything looks good on the power unit cycles, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. A bit of understeer when trailing the car ahead. They're going to be giving off dirty air, which is going to affect our tyres, so try to get past. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. gap to the car ahead is around 2 seconds. So we're leading our teammate by 6.7 seconds. Keep pushing, you're gaining on the car ahead. Job, nice overtake. teammate behind, 11.5 seconds. Okay, mate, we've got some clear track around us now, so let's use it and make this next lap a quick one. Let's go. Target. Really good job. No need to worry about the tyre condition for now, everything's looking good. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap. Right, let's go. Come on. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Watch out for the car behind. They're only 2 seconds down on you and might try and overtake if you make a mistake. Stay focused. You're leading the pack. That's P1. And that's Lando behind. Less than a second separates you. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. And 11 laps to go. Coming in for his stop now. Caution, caution. Okay, clear. Okay, mate, lap times are a little erratic at the moment. We need consistency, so let's try and stabilise them. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 17.1 seconds. Condition still looking good. We hit the target. Nice work. you know, we're getting some strange readings from a couple of the sensors. I don't think you need to be worried, just some bad data. So keep doing what you're doing. I'll let you know if we notice any genuine problems. Final lap of the race. Fantastic drive, that's just fantastic. Amazing, you deserve that race win. Well done, mate.
That's it for another magnificent Canadian Grand Prix, and they've hung on to take a sublime victory here today.
This is a result that's going to really matter for them. A good haul of points today, and it's consistency across the board that's going to keep them in this title battle.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure. And no doubt, they'll be celebrating tonight. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't